As we learned earlier, tables and charts and plots give us a visual representation of what the data look like. But now we're going to look at trying to calculate single numbers that also tell us something about what the data look like. One number will tell us about the variation or the spread of our data. We'll learn about that next time. For now, we want to look at what is the most typical case. We call this levels of central tendency. What does the center of the data look like? What's the most typical case in our data? Now, we have to know what level of measurement we're using first before we determine which statistic to calculate. Once we figure that out, then we know where to go from there. So let's say we have a nominal variable. Remember, a nominal variable just has distinct categories that can't be put in any order. Because of that, you can't calculate something like an average because these things are just names. You can't calculate the average of hair color or gender. It doesn't make sense. Even if you put numbers on those categories, you could actually physically calculate it, but there's no average hair color or average gender. It just doesn't make sense. So we have to calculate a different measure of central tendency. What we do with nominal data is actually calculate something called the mode. And the mode is very simple. It's the easiest thing to understand. It's just the category that shows up most often. So for example, if you've got data with 20 students in it, for example, and 12 of them are male and 8 of them are female, the mode is 12. The most common category of gender is male. Now let's look at another kind of statistic that you're probably already very familiar with. You're used to calling it the average. Now, technically, we like to use the term mean. And you'll see it sometimes in your textbook as X bar, an X with a little line over the top of it. The mean is simply the average score of all the items that you're looking at. Now, when can you use the mean? You can only use the mean when you're using ratio level data. So sometimes people will use that with an ordinal variable. So let's look at the t-shirt sizes again. Small, medium, large, extra large, and double XL. Someone might put a number on all those 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then try to take the average of that. Technically, you're not supposed to do that. You can do that. It's not the best idea. We'd like to do something different than that, but it can be done sometimes. Most of the time, though, the mean is calculated on ratio level variables. Remember, ratio level variables are distinct categories that can be ordered, and then you can tell the difference between categories. So let's use the example of weight that we used before. You have 50 people in a room, have them all stand on the scale. You'll have some people who are very heavy. You have some people who are very light. You can add up all those scores, divide by the number of people you have in there, and get a score that says this is the most typical weight. One way to think about means, I think, that is visually useful is to think about putting everybody on a line where their categories are. So you put all the people who weigh 100 pounds here and the people who weigh 200 pounds here on this bar that has a pivot in the middle. The mean will always try to find that balancing point in there. And so you'll have 100-pound people over here and 200-pound people over here, and the mean will be exactly where that balance is. The last measure of central tendency is called the median. Now, the median just means the middle score. And so let's say you have some people, one person weighs 100 pounds, then 125, 150, 175, and 300 pounds. So it's a spread of people here. But the middle person weighs 150 pounds. That's the median, 150 pounds. It's just the middle score. So why would you use the median? It's just the middle score. Why don't we use the mean score? Should be the same thing, right? Well, it's not. Let me give you an example of how the mean sometimes can be biased by extreme values. Let's look at house prices. Most houses in a city cost around, let's say, $200,000. And you could say the average price of those houses is $200,000. But consider some towns have one or two houses that are extremely expensive, $10 million houses. What's going to happen to the mean there? Remember this idea of balance. The mean is trying to find the center of all the data. If you have a bunch of houses that cost $200,000, and then you have two or three houses that cost $10 million, that mean is going to be drawn towards those extreme values. The median won't be. The median won't budge very far. It'll still be around the middle value there. So it still gives you a good sense of what the typical house price is in that town. Just as I said with level of measurement, measures of central tendency are also fundamental to statistics. We use those calculations in almost all the statistics that we use from here on out. So you really need to learn this material. So pay special attention to how we calculate modes, medians, and means in this segment.